Welcome back, everybody, here to our coverage of Kaipi going up against CIS Rejects. I'm Demi One, joined by Ryu. We are back again. The vault would have no break in it whatsoever, but almost an hour has passed since we started this game. Are you holding up there, Ryu?
Isn't this the original start time?
Yeah. No. That was actually an hour ago. That was an hour ago. That's because we ended the previous series 2 hours ago. And then Dota 2 got patched.
That was just like 5 minutes.
Yeah. But there's a whole bunch of new Dota TV tickets that were added and everything else. So it was like, okay, this is amazing. Okay, so we're into the game. For those of you who have only just joined us, welcome to the game. We are running a Kaipi redraft, even though I had a couple of words to come with me in the break. And quote the man himself, not that greedy.
that's an understatement.
Yeah. But I did get their plan. So their plan is to run a dual offlane. So that's how they're going to try and balance their draft out a little bit more, by running a dual offlane.
Dual offlane against this tri-lane? I will be eating my diapers if this works out. I mean my shoes.
I'm just the messenger, man. Like, I'm not the eater of, like, feces diapers.
I mean, I wouldn't put anything on first. I mean, I'll just...
So we were already slightly negative about Kaipi's draft, primarily because of the high levels of greed. It takes a long time for all the heroes to come online, and creating space for these heroes will be a difficult task. But let's see how it goes. To start with, the first rune, it's going to go the way of Iceberg. He'll be able to get that onto his Windranger. The top rune is being babysat by a lion, but it'll be going into the hands of Cancel so we can get this nice and early bottle. So Kami does the block. The Ember Spirit will be the safe laner. Bone 7 will be the off lane Bat Rider in this game. And they'll run Lion on the top. And we'll watch where Come With Me moves. He's probably going to play this very much like a roaming Earthshaker. CIS lanes are pretty obvious. It's the Tuskar who did the shard block on top. So just trying to throttle this lane out as much as he can. It puts the Slark as well as the Winter Wyvern down on the bottom lane. This is almost a suicide lane for a Batrider because he can't Firefly himself away. And then the roaming always want to fly Earthshaker, which Come With Me is now playing.
Oh, the pounce!
With.
Come on,
he missed it.
Missed it. Yeah, that would have probably been the death too. That's very unfortunate.
To say the least, yeah.
I just don't even know how he moved that way too. It's like he picked a creep. Really weird aggro, but...
Top lane. Afterlife's gonna get chipped down a little bit. He's actually waiting for Besser to level up his Searing Chains, but looks like he's waiting until he can get both Flame Guard and Searing Chains together. Or he's gonna, like, get up in the face of Afterlife. We should also point out too that CIS Reject's lineup is a little bit unusual. Because they are playing with four stand-ins in this game.
It's blocked in top. He took so much damage. He went from 4 to half HP. That's just a good...
Want to see bottom lane instead. Come With Me is the... Wait, do they have... There's no Dire Observer Ward over here. Always want to fly. He wants to get out to get this Fissure Line. That's the dream right now. And Come With Me walks over it. And the Fissure Line is not a reality.
Yeah, so kind of going to want to get level 2 for the Slark. There it is. That maybe they should have waited for that. Now he got the Essence Shift. This isn't really good against the Batrider, but... for taking off the sticky napalm, but it will, however, do a lot more DPS in this lane. Now they're going to go for it here on Come With Me, but... the boy attacks low.
They don't have enough damage. If you had Splinter Blast at the first level from Winter Wyvern, it actually still wouldn't have been enough to kill off Come With Me, but it would have brought him very, very close.
Yeah, the attack slow from the Void was too much. If they had a Fissure there, it could have potentially gotten the kill, but...
Mid lane. Iceberg's just going ham. Nightstalker's actually going to be killed by a neutral creep, but then perfect shackle to power shot. The Windrun will let him evade the attacks from the tower, and he can get the bottle in, trigger the south, and this mid lane has already been heavily won. It's 14-5 up against 5-1. It's the CS between the Windranger as well as the SF.
that's just what happens, and now he's got boots already. He's gonna have quick phase boots. That's a nightmare against a Shadow Fiend when you have all that bonus damage. Then you can easily keep up with the attack sometimes. So.
It's not even just the bonus damage. It's the fact that you don't have any souls in the SF after dying. Snowball's gonna come in, and he's gonna lose even more of his souls. The Shan's damage as well as block do the work. And Windranger now takes a second kill on cancel. Kaipi, in a world of hurt. A greedy draft, and you already lost your mid solo twice. And because it's so greedy, your lion is just doing pulls and finding farm. He's not doing stacks. And it's not like the Radiant side with the SF where you can just like lean yourself into your jungle and grab yourself a quick stack nice and quick. It's a lot more difficult.
At this rate, Shadow Fiend might have to go to the jungle himself just to farm.
They got the leash as well. And Bone 7, they gotta hold him there longer. The Flame Breeze is gonna push him back. And with the nice Firefly, he will be able to escape, but yeah.
I mean, Bone 7 is getting levels in the offlane. That's, I guess, the one saving grace. He's also going to get this creep wave here, but it's. They also can just keep setting up for the Fissure into the Pounce, so. With this Firefly being on cooldown, I don't know how much. I don't know how much Bone 7 can get. This is going to be a lot of pressure on the tier 1 tower, and he can't even get close now.
If he does, he'll just end up feeding a kill.
I wonder if it would have been worth it for him to use the Mango just to pull the creep wave with the Flame Break.
It might be, but at the same time, like, it'd only be delaying the inevitable. Because CISR will just fall back and then attack again later on. Like, yeah, this is the catapult wave. Are they going to TP in more help? Because Come With Me is not going to be successful here. The Fissure will go, the Leash will actually latch onto him, and Goblack's right behind him. They do still have a Cold Embrace, so even if Kaipi try and turn this one around, they could just be hurt even more. And Come With Me, Donato Roshan, the big man's going to punch him. Able to do it.
So, I would say Kaipi is getting a lot of lucky breaks in this game so far. Maybe not in the mid lane, but definitely on the Batrider early on, and then now there for the Night Stalker. They could be bleeding a lot more, but still, we can talk about, I guess, the Ember Spirit now. Once his rotations come in, then the team fights maybe will start turning around for Kaipi.
So with his rotations, are we looking for like the early game kind of build? Or you actually get like something like an urn over an Ember Spirit and get him to fight early on? Is that the play?
Maybe. I feel like Ember Spirit, you still need a bottle. No matter what, or Aquila, I still think you need the bottle always, because you're always going to go back to base. It just, it's like having a tinker in your team. You're always going to want to use that abuse. And afterwards, I would say maybe even to a drums, like they really have to fight early on. Like the most early game build, magic wand, drums, phase boots even maybe, or if you really want to run at people, or if you want to just survive, just get the strength treads.
What Bone 7 has been reduced to. Fireflying and sticky napalming for one camp. This Batrider. To give himself like 8 CS now. But you are right, he did find a lot of levels, so that last two timing isn't going to be terrible. Right, they shard and power shot into the trees. Cancel backed up very early on. That's a great thing for him, especially up against a double damage rune. Windranger, who now. Oh no! The Shackle and Focus Fire with the DD rune. Oh, that's not the dream.
Like whoever goes to these lanes is gonna be food. It's just free food.
The only food right now is the Shadow Fiend. He's died three times. Someone
but yeah, bottom
lane around the lane, but like he got dropped pretty low, but they can't finish the job just yet.
Yeah, I was watching them go on him. It's just full HP to 1/4 of your HP, and that happens for the Batrider too. And then you can't even stay in lane.
Hi, Lion. Stop, bro.
Oh, he's blocked too.
Yeah, but the shards, that's gonna block him a secondary time. Okay, that power shot was a very big miss.
He was trying to CS, but he actually didn't get it.
This is worth the steal. You're about to take a triple stack right now. The cancer wants to come over and grab this, and Kaipi are gonna contest it. The mana isn't terrific for CISR, but they've held on to their mana on the Earthshaker. Komi just walks up. So they snowball in to Come With Me. There's no mana for a shard, so instead he'll pop off the sigil as SF competes for the CS and Visa. He's gonna come in, Iceberg gives away his life. That's actually quite big. They went to contest up the camp, and now they're gonna be losing two heroes, both the Earthshaker and the Windranger.
Yeah, all in all, in the end, not worth it at all. Giving the Ember Spirit these kills, that's one of the other tempo controllers in this game. Shadowfiend is just going to be playing catch up until he can get the mech, but you get these kills on the Ember, you get these kills on the Nightstalker, that's going to help them a lot in the early game, and speaking.
And you can't afford to help him. This Snowball now is actually going to get the kill on the Tusker. Nighttime might wear off, but with a Spirit jump in, one charges to get the Flame Guard up. Afterlife going to throw out the shards, just try and block him out, but Iceberg, all he wants to do is try and get a revenge kill over on Come With Me. Beast is doing a very good job of blocking him out, especially when Kansas hit it. Hit all three razors, and that's big for him. That's the bonus souls in as well. And leveling the scoreboard up at 4 apiece, ISR biting off a lot more than they can chew.
Yeah, we were talking about it earlier, if nobody was listening. It was just like, alright, so one thing's going to happen. Either you're going to get a lot of kills, Snowball, and win the game, or you're going to dive too deep. And then they're just going to have immediate TP reactions and great rotations from Kaipi, and they're just going to turn it around. And meanwhile, Bone7 just on his own, got his level 6 now. He didn't get his ulti, however, on Bone7. So, you're going to have to wait till level 7.
He's farming, man. He understands the ulti won't do jack until he's got the extra cash. So maybe that's the reason why that you get Sticky Napalm, Firefly up once more. And the Flame Break change-up really makes it really worthwhile putting an early point in it.
Yeah, I've seen people max Flame Break too. It does an insane amount of damage, but
it's actually in ways more efficient than Firefly. But at the same time, you can't.
It's just too much mana.
Yeah, that's kind of it. Like the basic mechanic of Firefly, the cost of Firefly is just it's just too good for farming up stacks. But if you want to win during team fights, hell yeah, Flame Break the whole way.
You can't Firefly and Flame Break. That's like 240 mana. You can't efficiently spam these out unless you have your bottle. In which case, normally you don't have it up and running that early because, yeah, what you want to get is the Bat Boots and Tranquil Boots and just run around freely so you have that max movement speed. Else you're just going to be picked off all the time.
Jungle stacks are real. Cancel will fail his, but still successful one from Buffney. Even able to get rid of that Observer Ward, cost him a little bit of life because of the power shot, but fine. Slark can't finish off this tier 1 tower. In fact, Bone7's going to come down. There's some easy CS for him to grab. And underneath this tower like this, when he's also got Flame Break, he can actually outplay the Slark. Even if Slark does have his Shadow Dance already up. With a double
damage. Probably wouldn't need another hero there. Yeah, this double damage.
That's it.
Can they do with this? I mean, they could have had the mid tier 1 by now, for sure. Instead of diving and getting those S and the creep camp, they could have instead traded for mid, but this should be enough pressure with the double damage rune to, you know, take a tower. Their first one's gonna be on bottom. Oh, Fissure, Bone7.
Yeah, lock him in, and there's the control factor they need. Bone7's gonna drop 30 seconds on the sideline. That also bought space for the Earthshaker to get the kill. And these death animations are like something is really off in Source 2. The bat just turns himself upside down. All you see is this mouth as well as like underbelly. The bat.
It likes to change up things, you know? They don't want to keep anything the same. Everything's new.
Quick pause out from cancel. It's going to reconnect back in again. Assuming because of some kind of frame, because of some kind of ping issue.
It's his death. Once he's died 3 times, it's changed, so he has to reconnect, so it changes the way he dies. But he's got a buckler now. It's not looking terrible because of that kill that he did manage to get. He's at 49 CS. He is behind, but I want to say 40, at least 15 of those are probably the jungle or something, because he did retreat into it early on.
Yeah. I'd actually say most of it is the jungle. So you're all right. He had to give up the mid lane. And this is the second time it's happened too, where the SF moves over into the jungle and Come With Me takes up the mid lane. So this Nightstalker, hilariously enough, because he got involved in a couple of kills. Yeah, Come With Me died twice. You've got 2 kills and 1 assist on this Nightstalker. 11 minutes in. Doesn't really seem that great, but when you're running such a greedy lineup like what Kaipi is doing, it's actually quite good. Nightstalker is able to fight in the mid game with this start. The Lion's already got level 6, So while you don't have a lot of items on him, he's about to finish up his Tranquil boost in 15 gold, but kind of enough for a Lion, because Tranquils as well as Mana Drain, Lion's normally known as the fourth position because you have to get Blink Dagger money on him. But he's also really good for utility. Through both Mana Drain and Tranquil Boots, you never have to use any kind of consumables. So all that extra money can go into things like Observer Wards and Smokes and that kind of jazz.
Yeah, it's the same concept as the Crystal Maiden, where you just have that aura always up all the time, and then Tranquil Boots. You always need to have Tranquil Boots too, just because of that movement speed. And it helps a lot when you're playing these supports that have, you know, less movement speed, like Crystal Maiden, Lion. Really need to get into these team fights. So it's an all-around good item here. And I'm trying to think now, like, what is going to happen? Because it's almost nighttime and 40 seconds here, or 35, going to be precise. And what are they going to do with Kaipi? Are they going to, you know, farm up? Batrider just died. He's not going to have a quick Blink Dagger whatsoever.
I can answer that question, man. When you go greed, you eat. You just keep feeding and feeding. I mean, no, sorry. That's the other way around. You keep getting fed. So you... Bro, that was an analogy going horribly, horribly wrong. They just keep farming. Like, because
you haven't had your dinner, Toby. I'm going to feed you after this series.
I am a little peckish. But yeah, Kaipi, all they got to do is just keep farming. Get that Blink Dagger on the Batrider. When nighttime hits around, the Batrider and the Nightstalker, they go hunting. Ember Spirit, as well as the SF, just keep farming in the meantime. If there's a chance for them to fight because CISR are like diving into towers, TP in and attack. Counterattack. And just keep going that way. You're getting the only mech on the SF, which means there will be some times when Kaipi will be looking to force down buildings. That should still only be the SF joining like Lion, Nightstalker, Batrider as a four group. Let the Ember Spirit farm and just keep farming. Get the Battle Fury up and running and become that complete menace you know the Ember Spirit can be. So yeah, that would be, I think, in my mind, the plan for KP.
Yeah, speaking of Ember Spirit, you look at his build right now. He has Poor Man's Shield, Magic Wand Bottle, and Aquila. He has a lot of regen, and he has extra stats. A lot of survivability right now. He doesn't really need to go drums. He's probably saving up for Boots of Travel here, just so he can always be farming, split pushing, and then join his team. This is not really a safe game for him, though, to be split pushing that much. So
yeah,
I think he's just saying, like, hey, I know my team potentially might feed here. We're going to have to split push the lanes if they get picked off. Well,
what catches him out?
Fissure, Snowball, with Wyvern ulti, Shadowblade, Slark, and
Snowball
Jack.
Can't really get him, though.
True.
You have to have a Blink Walrus Punch, almost a Blink Shackle, because you can't just spirit
away. But I think the Fissure into the... Like, they have a lot of setup things. Like, Fissure can set up to anything, and then Wyvern ulti can set up to anything. Yeah. They have long cast range.
But that's kind of it for me, though. Like, it's Fissure and Wyvern ulti. That's the only thing is it can really control out the Ember. Because you're not going to... Like, any kind of projectile. Snowball is still a projectile. Shackle is a projectile. And Slark's Leash can't... Like, it doesn't hold the Ember Spirit in position as long as he's got a defensive spirit. He should be able to jump himself away. I'm wondering if it might be worthwhile prioritizing a little bit more farm area to Afterlife, so we can get to that Blink Dagger. Once you get that, then you're hunky dory. But then again, maybe you're still relying on Walrus Punches as your only controller.
You could even still go back on Windranger to go for the Blink Dagger here. Casual point booster isn't too bad if you're really thinking you need more initiation. Which, I don't really think they need it, so just having more survivability.
Come with me, come on top. Puts the illusion behind the tower to start with, and then runs at him. Afterlife's already used his shards and goes in for the snowball. Chasing come with me all the way over into the tree line. You'll still be able to connect on him. Because he's so far down, there's nowhere the Ember Spirit's going to jump. He did have three spirits available to commit, but besides against it.
Bone 7. Oh, nice stack. Triple stack, baby. Here we go. Flame on, and Really? This is gonna be easy.
You going Fantastic Four on us?
Hey, you know, I haven't seen... I've only seen two of those. Is there three?
There's three. There's the new one that came out, but it was mediocre, to say the least. Hilariously enough, I actually watched Fantastic Four last night! the old 1995 movie.
How was that one?
Well, it was terrible as always, but...
So as good as this game right now, Anshkin, this game is great. This game is great. No, this is a really... Just relax, Toby. I'm just joking. Bottom lane? Oh, no, I'm just kidding.
Not yet, man. Not yet. The lion walked out a little bit earlier, then maybe there'll be the chance. This observer ward sees... Always want to fly retreating. But it's so difficult to get aggressive. Like, you know the observer ward had to be in place then. That's the only reason he would make a walk like that. So the observer ward's over the top of the Roshan pit, which means also always want to fly. Sees Bone 7 coming down for this rune. Flame break, gonna push always want to fly down. Fired by him. And then the fact they're gonna snowball the Bone 7, he ran out of Firefly. He ran out of juice. The finger of death, however, it knights out the slug. The kill from above. Tony wants to keep fighting. He does actually have a Fury Darkness, right. And he just gets short of the double damage. Always want to fly, keep the sun going. With a totem hit, he can inflict a heavy chunk of damage into that Night Stalker. Echo Slam as well, but Ember Spirit's shield protects him from those of it. The ultimate coming out from SF2 will do the work. Not enough to find himself a kill, but it keeps the rest of CISR focused on the. Nice. Oh, Kaipi. The Ember Spirit's able to do his thing. They actually are getting kills. They're getting better advantages during fights, Kaipi. And they're...
That just finger onto the Slark basically set up the whole thing. That was a nice snowball save coming in against the Requiem, though. They didn't take damage, but... Man, that was a Lion MVP moment right there. And come with me on the hunt. Oh, Black. Be in trouble here.
He still hasn't silenced him yet. Throws out the urn. Now he can actually go for the silence, but the Arctic Burn flies out. Kami actually dodges the Fissure of Always Wanna Fly. It locks him in. And in fact, he'll silence on the Earthshaker, so there's no secondary stun. Try and juke it left and right, but the Creek Web getting in trouble. But there's his help. And it will come in. Gets the slide of this Flutter Fist and the Searing Chains over on the Earthshaker. The Cold Embrace will protect him. While, come with me, pumped up into towards the air by that Walrus Punch. The SF, unsure where he wants to really fight, throws out one raise into the Tuskar, but doesn't have enough damage to find himself a real kill here.
Oh no.
Oh wow, that's problematic. He's still got the mech, however. So I'm not seeing... I was about to say, I'm not seeing a problem until it gets shackled. But what are you supposed to do? Like, there's trees here, there's here, everywhere! So Windranger is going to get a shackle on you.
It'd be funny if it was on the baby Black Dragon too. Yeah, that would just be the nail in the coffin right there. But this is... Yeah, this is just the same thing that happened to CIS when they dove past the tower. Like, why are you going past the tier 1 tower? They're going diving on the tier 4 or tier 2 tower. There's no reason for Kami to really be back there. It's just not beneficial at all. Mm. Just baited his team into a really bad position.
And now Kaipi start to lose out heavily. They're going to lose the tier 1 tower in mid. Puts them two towers behind that of CISR, even though I think that bottom tower was denied previously. This opens up Roshan, which CIS have obviously made a point of. They've got two observer wards on left and right side of the Rosh pit. They want to know the second Kaipi goes anywhere near it.
All
they're gonna come for kills. Is that a fiend? Now there's no camp, he's waiting for it to spawn, and the spirit over the top breaks the smoke.
Yeah, they knew, Kaipi knew that they were smoking. Something felt really fishy. They didn't see anyone defending bottom lane. That's an easy tell, right, when you're having wave. Or maybe they're scared of an enemy smoke, but in this case, it was pretty easy. But Bone7 now has his blink online. He is still, I want to say he's still not as useful as you want him to be. He still needs to be have a 4 staff to be really impactful. They have so many things just to counter him still. They have like Wyvern ulti, if you're good at a Slark, Dark Pact in Time, Shackles, Fissure, like everything counters Batrider this game, and he needs to have a 4 staff, and as well as he needs to have a BKB.
Alright, so Tier 1 tower is going to go down bottom. under attack. So at least push Bone 7 towards some of those items you were talking about. This is the observer was a little bit too far away. He can't reach him. He can't reach the Slark. The Slark also goes invis. Bone 7 will do the same. Killing that invis rune. But this just guarantees the tier 1 tower in the bottom lane. But Cancel's backing up.
I mean, both teams are playing really scared right now.
Like, you have an observer ward and an ice socket to restrict vision and...
Well, it could be smoked up too.
Could be. That's why you just put the Nightstalker, like, in this little tree line here. With this observer ward there, you are going to break the smoke when someone rotates down. And you've got the movement speed to run yourself away. So there's no reason to play that kind of defensive nature. Unless it's by pure paranoia. You think a Slark has managed to Shadowblade himself in. Bone 7 needs help. He really wants Iceberg here.
No, the person who needs help is always want to fly, man. You got it wrong.
Mysterian chains and silence. There's no way back out of this one until the Slark comes in. Pounces over on Combi, but that's a 10 stick charge Nightstalker. Get them off, and very, very tanky, only able to get a void in return. Bone 7 was fireflying himself up, but couldn't get there in time to help his teammate out.
That's a better trade for Kaipi, because Urshaker almost had his Blink Dagger. Like, he's really being silent right now, where the team always want to fly. Creeping up on that Blink Dagger, and then when he has that online, I'm going to be very worried for Kaipi. So they have the BKB. So, well, talking about that, BKB almost... How much? It's not even almost complete. I thought he might have one more component, but SF is really hurting this game. 1-4.
I'm actually wondering if BKB is the best choice for him here. Like, I know there's a lot of magical damage coming out, but... Do you still need SF to be a fighter, or do you get enough of that out from the Ember Spirit?
Yeah, at this stage, when you're so far behind, you have to go for a BKB. It's kind of like the same situation. Sometimes Quops have to go in. Or, you know, a Storm Spirit, like, last-ditch effort. You don't want to, but in this case, you have to. And just hope that you'll have enough lockdown and burst from the Lion, and then the DPS is going to come from the Ember Spirit.
Just want to do a public service announcement. If you are tuning in right now, we are doing multiple streams for Join Dota at the moment. Cap and Turk are streaming out the defense, our Join Dota tournament. You can find that one over, like, at joindota.com. The links are all over there. Got Complexity going up against Power Rangers right now, as well as Monkey Business going up against ATN will be the next games. And we have more defense games coming up tomorrow night. And, of course, the D2CL. I can't give you a date when the next game will be, but it should be scheduled pretty soon. We're at the point where finish one game, the result then dictates the next matchup, and then we try and schedule it as early as we can. So... Dota 2 action coming out every day of the week. Even WCA qualifiers coming out this weekend. But if you want to sign your team up for that one, if you don't know about that one, there's actually like $13,000, $14,000 prize pool for an open qualifier. And the winner gets to go to China for WCA, where there's over $100,000 prize pool. I think it's actually up around $200,000 to $300,000, but I don't have a confirmed number on that yet. Yeah, go check it out, boys.
Alright, I'm on it. Yeah. I'm on it.
Get your team in, Ryu.
Me and you.
No, I gotta cast.
Why cast when you can play?
Because I like casting and I suck at playing.
Jeez.
That went down. Sorry, I'm no TI winner. Always on a fly, gonna get fingered, dragged back. They will be protected a little bit in the shackle. It latches up on Come With Me. Always on a fly, will still go down. And Come With Me with these sick charges. Can he get away? Nah, they're gonna curse him up and then ball him up as well. Snowballing in to get the kill, making it a one-for-one trade-off. Slark wants more out of this, but all he can find is the Ember Spirit, which is not a kill.
Alright, there it is. So he did go for the Blink Dagger first and then the Ags. They were really feeling kind of pressured where they needed another initiator, a good initiator. So now that he has Ags online with the Wind Ranger, that Night Stalker kill will be tremendously easy now. So... Looking over at the side of IP, what do they have to do? That's a good space-making kind of play for your Shadow Fiend. Like, you really need him to get back in the game. They really need this BKB if they want to hold their fights. And I want to say that was a really good lasso, just setting up, you know, the initial fight. Even though it was only a one-for-one, I think a lot came... I think it's benefiting Kaipi a lot, just because I'm not sure how you feel about their late game.
Kaipi's late game craps all over CISs. Even with your Echo Slam, the Ember Spirit got caught with his shields down. Like, CIS have, like, grab material, like, grab abilities, but up against something like a Blink Lasso, it's difficult to say in the late game that CIS have a better advantage there. And then you've still got a big SF ulti, you've still got the Nightstalker vision. As long as Nightstalker can stay alive, but that's made very, very difficult. A great vision lineup, and they don't even get to late game at this rate. Iceberg can be put under with a cold embrace to cancel. He doesn't really have much more to give. He's getting it all stolen away by this slot, shifting out the essence. 27 has to blink himself away. So Kaipi missed the initial engagement. And then that blink dagger from the Earthshaker like, goes to work again. Perfect vision line. The Requiem of Souls is kind of nothing. Curse felt early, but without the Nightstalker, there was nothing for Kaipi.
Yeah, kind of late game would be the sense where you have to, whoever gets the jump feels like they'll kind of win it. But right now, CIS, it just feels like their heroes are just geared more towards these team fights when you don't have all your items. Like, if they have BKBs on Kaipi, yeah, sure, these team fights could be very even. But
yep,
when you're just getting locked down the whole time by Shackles, Fissures, I mean, this is just great plays all around coming in from CIS.
It's the scary mid game. It's just a scary mid-game from CIS. Their heroes all come to like the perfect, the sweet spot in this time of the game, like 25 minutes to 30 minutes in. They're loving this. Kaipi want to keep dodging. This Ember Spirit wants to keep split pushing. He's got Battle Fury BTs only at the moment. There's no Chrysalis, there's no Daedalus up for him. The SF still does not have this BKB 25 minutes in. And the Nightstalker is trying to now go in towards an Aghanim Scepter. These last, like, 3-4 deaths in the last 10-15 minutes, it's difficult, man.
Yeah, it's just because they need so much farm, as you talked about earlier. Just, like, every single one of them needs so much farm on
Lion's still going for Blink Dagger. Like, Buffney thinks he can still get to the Blink Dagger. 27 thinks he can finish up a BKB as well. But they need to do exactly what Beast is doing right now. Like, you just farm up the Radiant jungle, take everything that CISR have got, and then still try and keep farming your own, but this SF is so fearful. And rightly so, it's a smoke gank from CISR, and they're gonna find two. But come with me, the only one left behind. The Ember Spirit just spirits himself away. IP will be able to escape with just the death of Nightstalker.
I wanna say that death isn't all so bad, but they're probably gonna get a rush out of it. So it is gonna be, they have a double damage on Rin Ranger. Does he have buyback? No, they're not even gonna contest, so. But that pickoff, gonna transition to the Roche.
You
the reason
have
why
that Ember Spirit in there, however.
Yeah, he can steal it. You just keep a Remnant outside right now, and then you can potentially, you can even slide a Fist steal it too, so.
I remember there was a guy over on Reddit that was bitching about that. Players keep jumping into the Spirits, not jumping out at the right time with Spirit Control. Like, why'd you use slide a Fist to try and grab the Aegis in the middle of the slice?
But I think ultiing in is way more, like, Slight is not as reliable.
Oh, the jump! Bone 7 goes in! There's your jump in with the Spirit, but no, he missed the timing for it! Batrider is down, Roshan is taken, the Aegis Immortal is
is on the ground forever, alright, well. that would have been the easiest Aegis kill ever.
No, Roshan, who's got this? I don't know, you take, I don't know, who's it's taking?
It's not like two people just came in.
Mine!
Not like two people just came into the Roche pit at all. What's the hurry?
You're doing fine. Relax. The Scotty's almost done for the Slark. Like, his stats are getting better and better. The Ember Spirit still has more net worth than him, and he is about to complete up the Crystallis. The Wind Ranger tops them all with a Blink, Aghanims, and 3.2k on Iceberg. Okay, what's the dream item for the Wind Ranger in this game now?
I would say MKB. You need MKB for the Crippling Fear, mostly. Oh, the Lion just got pieced out.
I think also Come With Me is going to join him. That pounce off cooldown, and there it is. Pouncing on Nightstalker, always on a fly. Control move maneuver is perfect. And that's actually the Scotty with those two kills. Gave him enough money to finish the job.
Yeah. I mean, he could still go Daedalus. Daedalus does a lot more DPS than MKB, but just to have the potential of Shadow Fiend, he can always go for the Butterfly late game. Ensure that up. The Crippling Fear is, I want to say, the biggest issue. And though. Like, it's just up to what he wants to do. He can, honestly, he needs a BKB too, but if he has his Aegis right now, you really don't need to have it. Then you can play as aggressive as you want.
Bottle on the sidelines and grab yourself something. But I'm down with that, man. And then get the BKB up next. Where are you off to, Dodo?
He's got a null talisman he picked up. He's doing good, man. How much is that? I forget. 230?
Is it null talisman? 13?
Oh, no, when you sell it. Sell it.
I don't know the sell cost.
See, half. Oh, it's 235. It's gotta be
235. 470 to buy.
Yeah, imagine the world of Dota with everything costing 230. Null talisman bracers.
I know, that's why like, he said 230. I'm like, wait. I didn't know if things have got a lot cheaper, but back in my day.
Bone 7 is fishing in the wrong place.
Yeah, there's a lot of fish. There's none he can catch. Blaine breaks the creep wave from behind
he's
to get him to
look. He's got 4 TB scrolls.
Why?
He's probably he would have spammed it.
He might have also taken them all. Because then they actually appear as individual item slots in your,
right.
your inventory. So he actually legitimately bought 4 TP scrolls of his own.
Probably got flamed for it when he was on Cloud 9. Still remembers that base race where they lost to RTZ.
Wait, just to RTZ? Was it only to RTZ?
And
just because he was playing Lycan.
I'm in S4.
Playing Lycan. Oh, Baron 7. He's on the cliffside just in time. Time breaks him down. And a dance from Slark also being committed, but yeah. The CIS side is going for the bad trade-off now. They take tier 1 and tier 2 tower for the trade-off of their own tier 2 tower on the bottom lane. It poses the question, who pushes faster now?
Oh, definitely an Ags Wind Ranger. But Chestbane does a good amount of damage too, I mean, but that's only just because of the souls. He doesn't really have the Saint Janasha as you were talking about, doesn't have the butterfly for the attack speed. So I would definitely say the Wind Ranger. And speaking of her, Iceberg picking up at Lincoln's is...
You wanted one way to break free of that crippling fear, that's one way to do it. But more than likely it's for the last two problems.
Yeah. Biggest problem with the Lincoln's is, yeah, it'll help you for the lasso, but it doesn't help you with the lion blinking, because you can blink in, stun, and then...
It's not bad though for, like, the...
I think it's good. I think it's good. You can put it on your frontliner too, and... That'll be helpful. I'm surprised, you know, thinking about it, Lincoln's is really good too here, as well as the Lotus Orb. But I don't know if anybody will be able to pick that up. Only person I could see would be Afterlife, and I think he wants to get a Blink Dagger next, but...
I'm kind of it's okay with it for the Wind Ranger, because it's just stats and regeneration. Like, it's difficult to go wrong with that. And you've already got your Blink Dagger, which will put you in aggressive positions. The double Blink's now arriving for Kaipi. Both SF and line completeness at this time. It couldn't have come at a better time for Kaipi.
Oh, Aegis is about to run out. Right.
Ow. No.
Can't do math.
Boom. Alright, you can't read analog. That's not math, man. That's analog.
Yo, that clock is too sundialed. Too hard. Yeah, it is. It's the 2D version of a sundial.
That defeats of a sundial to have it in two dimensions. The level of science that you just broke is unbelievable. Oh, Iceberg, there's your Blink Lasso. They're able to drag him back. Cold Embrace mean there's no real magical damage connecting, but that Fissure Block will lock him into the Flame Break, pushes him back over again. Iceberg, he just takes all the damage. They kept him hexed up, so there's no Wind Ranger for this fight, but the Slark, he's jumping in there. He's stolen 15 of the essence from Come With Me. Can't find much more with no more Shadow Dance. In fact, the Ember Spirit killing off the Tuskar. Now they move to the Wyvern as well. Kill after kill, and in fact, 666, Devil is away. Running out through the bottom, Ember Spirit doesn't want to give it up here. Spirit's forward, Spirit's down, but not going to find the Slark.
Yeah, that's just playing really aggressive when you don't have the Aegis, and like I said, it's really easy to cancel the Lincolns there. It's not even all that hard. Always when a fly has an Echo Slam. He looks like he's on the prowl, but he needs somebody else if he really wants to kill Bisa. Unless he gets the creep wave. Oh, Slark is coming in.
That's the way to do it. Echo Slam once, Fissure, stun, boom. Ember Spirit down for 70 seconds, but buyback is available.
So, end of the day, 1-for-3 trade now. Definitely gonna go to the side of B a little bit, but with that Ember kill, it allows CIS to really push out the lanes again, and they can do whatever they want, I feel. Let's see, when's the next nighttime? Because that's going to be huge for Kaipi now that they have the eggs, and they should have the gym soon here.
I'm interested. Yeah, this SF's going to be in a little bit of trouble. He's just trying to bait. He's trying to bait the BKB, and that's exactly what he gets. But he can't get himself out. Even with the BKB, you still burn a BKB and your life. That's not the dream.
Yeah, I BKB does not stop Scotty.
It does not. You still keep getting slowed up. But you try to juke it around the tree anyway. Here's a question for you. The Aghanim's upgrade passive you get when you unobstruct vision during nighttime, is that removed by Silver Edge? So I'm assuming Hunter of the Night is removed. The Ag's upgrade. My process of, like, full process is it, no, it doesn't get removed.
I would feel like it should remove the nighttime for 5 seconds, making it day.
That would be OP.
But that's only when it uses it during the day. Like, and then when it's nighttime, I think it should just take away the obstructed vision. But going back to, I know why he BKB'd. I mean, the reason why he BKB'd because he was pounced and he wanted to break free of that so he could actually run and take a little bit less damage.
It's just understanding that you don't really have much to work with. Lion just gets popped. You might blink last super, but there's no one to do any kind of damage to the iceberg. And this time around, they're not fighting underneath towers. So Bone7 gonna get cursed up and controlled, punched into his own death. And even the Yule steps to control. That comes out from the Earthshaker. SF will get the Requiem of Souls off. But where is the real follow-up? He's going for the Razor. 666 is just tanking through most of the side of Fist Searing Chains, doing serious work. But the problem is that Cold Embrace giving the life back to Slark. He's able to leap himself away. The Ember Spirit will survive through all of this, but the SF would just... He just had a dieback. That's actually mid-racks right there.
Yeah, he buys back and he doesn't have his souls. If he had Requiem max souls, he could have done a lot in that teamfight, but he didn't. As you said, he bought back, and that's definitely a set of racks, if not more. They don't even have Bone 7 with Lasso when he comes up.
Yep.
I think this might be two sets here, yeah. This is...
The funny thing is, though, the greed brought this so close. Like, if Kaipi just had a little bit more, like, of an advantage gain during their fights in the mid game, they could have actually won this game and the greed would have paid off.
Maybe if Ember didn't just get picked off in the mid lane, and then them taking, like you said, taking a team fight outside of base when it's not nighttime, that's not smart.
They're actually getting ready to fight. Looks like a Bone7, Goblack, he's the man to be dragged back in that new Desolator coming in for the Ember Spirit, but they've just lost their line who blinked himself forward. So the Ember Spirit wants to go for more. A nice Searing Chains over on 2, but always want to fly. Echo spins back off cooldown. The Flame Guard just dissipated for the Ember Spirit. So now he's down as well. The blink back from the SF will help save him, but the Shackle, it latches over on 2. Always want to fly, gets the follow-up some. The Snowball's coming in as well. It rolls over the top of the SF to get behind the lines. Come on me is another target, and that's GG. They've lost too many players. 27-13, game one of this best of three series will go the way of the CIS rejects.
Yeah, and CIS rejects, they were kind of throwing them a bone, right? They were diving early on, giving them, and then IP did the same thing. They threw him a bone. Here, we'll dive past your tier one tower. We'll give you some kills that are not needed. And then it made the game kind of close, like you said. They were only down 5,000 gold the entire game,
yep,
which is not too much going into 36 minutes.